Imagine this. You just launched a new feature or adjusted your pricing. A few days later, conversions start to drop. Normally, you've got two options: wait for the next release or rush a fix and cross your fingers. But not with Qonversion. With remote config, you can tweak any feature in real time, from pricing experiments to user onboarding flows. You simply adjust your app's behavior on the backend and see changes reflected instantly in the user experience. In this video, I'm going to show you how to configure your app behavior in Xcode. Watch till the end, and I'll show you how to set up A/B tests in your app based on the configuration we go through now. Let's get to the code. So let's take a look at how we can use the powerful feature of Qonversion that is called remote config. First of all, what I'm going to show you before we do anything on their dashboard is just go walk you through a little bit through the demo project that I have created. This would, if I just started out, it would be an hour-long tutorial, and I just want to focus on the main features. So what I have over here is a content view, and I just want to say, okay, what is my information? Is it Qonversion, Rebeloper, or just, if I don't have anything, just a word. And if we're going to just simply run this app, you will see that currently we don't have anything set up. We are not fetching anything from remote config from Qonversion. It will just say hello world. Now, I just want to grab Qonversion and put it in there, hello Qonversion. So that's the whole setup. We have an app controller that has a Qonversion remote config model. That model basically just the info of string. You can add to this if you are having more than one variable, and we are going to get there how we are going to set all of this up. But basically it's just moving the info string out of the dictionary that we are getting from a Qonversion. And to make our lives even easier, I just created a decodable extension that is basically decoding the dictionary into our model. And after that, we are going to do this on the app delegate. Therefore, we do need a notification name, because we are going to use a notification center to notify us of the changes. Finally, on the we have the app controller. That's it, basically. I have the environment. We set that up as an environment. That's our starter project. Okay, so how are we going to get these remote configs from a Qonversion? Well, first of all, you need to log in. Let me just go to my browser, and then let's log in, create a new profile if you haven't already done so. And what I'm going to do is just create a new project and the project. And let me just go back to my Xcode project and grab my bundle identifier from right over here. I just want to name this kind of the same as my project, Xcode project. So I'm just going to remove that part. Okay. Let's click on next over here. Now, you may go and set up App Store. That's another thing. We do not need actually setting all of this up currently. If you are going to use kind of the main feature of Qonversion, like in-app purchases, you do need to have this set up. Let me know in the comments if you want a tutorial on that. So we're just going to skip this. So let's click on next over here. Installing the SDK. Well, let's do that. Let's go ahead and grab. Well, actually, I do have it right over here on my notes. Let's go to our Xcode project, select your project, package dependencies, click on plus, paste it in there. So it's github.com/conversion/conversion iOS SDK. Let's add that package. Tutorial time, we are having Qonversion version 5.12.4. Okay, so what's next? Let's go back to our Chrome. Let's click on next. Create products and entitlements. We don't need to create our products and entitlements for now, so let's just click over there. But we're not going to create it. Again, if you want to have a separate tutorial, go ahead and comment down in the comment section. Okay, so what we are going to do is create a remote config, and it can be found right over here. So click on remote config, and then let's create a new configuration. Let's have a configuration name. Yeah, usually you want to have this on your paywall. Therefore, yeah, basically it should just convey where your remote configuration kind of lives inside your application. So let's just have this as main paywall. And context key, we are going to use the context key to access this configuration, main underscore paywall. Okay, that's fine. We have that set up. Let's click on continue. Now, you see we have an empty payload. This is what we are going to provide our application as, you know, remote configuration. So let's click on add it right over here. And we are going to have a string variable key. Let's just have that as set as info. And the value, well, the value, let's just have it conversion. Let's just set that as conversion. Let's click on save. Now you see the key is info, and I have also set up my variable to be named info. This is important. If you are going to add some more, please do add to the conversion remote config codable model. And also note that we might have, let's just click on add it right over here. We can have numbers, booleans, JSONs, color, products, screens, a lot we can have right over here for the type. Okay, for now, you know, just tutorial's sake, this is a perfectly fine. Okay, now what we want to do next is basically initialize our conversion SDK. So let's just create, this has to be on the application did finish launching with options. So actually what we need to do is create an app delegate and link it to the main file. Let's do that. Let's create a new empty file, app delegate. There we go. Let's import Swift UI. Okay, let's and also while we are here, let's import conversion. There we go. And then we're going to have a class app delegate. Let's just use the AI suggested code right over here, and this one too. But we do not need the UI responder. We are not in a UI kit environment. We do need the application did finish launching with options. And before it returns to, let's set up our conversion. So first of all, we need to create a configuration. Now, what is this configuration? It needs a project ID and some other setup. Let's just start typing it out so you can see. So config, let config equals conversion. Conversion, there we go. Configuration, and you will see an initializer with the project key and a launch mode. Let's take care of the project key first. Let's go back to our browser and select settings. And here we go. Here is our project key. Let's copy that out, go back to Xcode and add it just over there. Now there is this launch mode. If you hit dot right over here, you will see that there are two ways, analytics and subscription management. Subscription management, you are going to use conversion for your in-app purchase management. This is not the case in this tutorial. We're just using a remote config. Analytics is more than enough right over here. And also, if you already have in-app purchases inside your project, like with StoreKit 2, for example, then you should use analytics. Okay. So this is our configuration, and now it's time to basically initialize our conversion with this config. So conversion, it's not start, but init with config, and we're just going to move that config right over there. Okay, so we have initialized our configuration. Let's see how this looks like. And I'm just running right over here, build and running, because I just want to make sure that I did not make any mistakes. Build is successful. We are still going to get only hello world because we are not fetching our remote config. Okay, so let's add that fetch. Let's go after our initialization. Let's start typing conversion.shared.conversion. remote config, and we want to use the one remote config with a context key and completion. Now, remember we created that context key? Let me just go back to remind you where we did that. In the remote config, we did not activate it. Good thing that I have come over here, because now you see there's some active drafts and archive. Let's go to draft, and this is our context key. This is what we are looking for. But we want to activate it. So let's select it and click on activate. Activate again, and now we should be able to see that under the active, there we go, under the active tab. So main paywall with the underscore is our context key. Let's just go back to our Xcode project and add main underscore paywall. There we go. Under completion, we are going to get back a remote config item and optionally an error. Both of them are optional, by the way, as you can see. So remote, remote config and error. First of all, let's take care. If there is any error, then we should display it. If let error, then print error fetching remote config. Otherwise, we would and if there is an error, then we just return. If there is no error, then we want to grab this remote config and do something with it. Now, we are in the app delegate. We want to move that data, you know, the info, into the content view right over here, more specifically into the app controller. Now, the app delegate, you know, this is kind of UI kit stuff. It can't access our content view, our app file. What we need to do is actually use Notification Center to move that remote config outside of our app delegate file. And that has to be done on the main thread. So let's just start adding a dispatch queue dot main dot async. And we are going to say Notification Center dot default dot post. Yeah, let me see if that's a good one. Yeah, you know, remote config fetch, that's not existing in our project. We are going to use the notification dot name dot conversion remote config. Remember, we added it right over here. Okay, and then object, not nil, but we are going to pass it along. So a remote config, just like that. And finally, we are returning true. Now, we need to get a hold of this. So in the app file, we are going to listen to our, you know, notification center. But before we do that, I just forgot that we also need to add our UI application app delegate adapter. So add UI application app delegate adapter. Well, it should be private. Let's just have that private. Var app delegate of type app delegate. So, this should work, but I prefer the other initialization, app delegate dot self. Okay, and then private var app delegate, and we don't have to set its type. Both of them will work. This is just more familiar for myself. So this will actually trigger the app delegate when we are launching it. So now what we want to do is listen to that notification. So on receive a publisher, and we are going to have notification center dot default, come on, dot default dot publisher for, and let's have the name added, notification dot name dot conversion remote config. So now we are listening to those changes. We are going to perform something here. We are going to get back an object. Okay, and finally we can use that object, extract the info and put it into the app controller. So first of all, we want to make sure that we do have an actual remote config. So guard let a remote config that is from Qonversion. Therefore, we need to import Qonversion right over here. So guardlet remote config equals object, but not object as remote config and else, object dot object. You know, we could just have this as remote, you know, something else, but this object has to be a type, and this has to be Qonversion dot remote config. So now that we have an actual remote config from Qonversion, we want to make sure that its payload is available and it is of a type of dictionary. So another guardlet statement, guardlet payload equals remote config dot payload. Well, we need to add some other stuff also right over here as string to any. There we go. Otherwise, again, we are going to return. Now that we do have our payload, we want to move it into this type of codable. So it's easier to use it in our Swift project. So that may throw, so do, we're going to have a do catch statement. Do catch, and let's print out, yeah, error of type error, that's fraud. It's a parsing error. We are going to say app controller dot Qonversion remote config equals, well, no, not that one, equals, and try Qonversion remote config with the payload. So let's just add that from with the dictionary. Initializer, just payload, come on, auto completion, just killing me, just payload, just like that. So if we can get a valid model from our payload dictionary, then just store it into the Qonversion remote config, and now we are done, because once this is updated, the content view will use that remote config and its info to replace the hello world. So let's build and run and let's see what happens. Build succeeded. And I don't know if you have blinked, you missed it, but world is being replaced with Qonversion. That's it. Now let's just see, you know, remote config. Why do we actually need this? Well, we can change these values on the fly. Even if your app is on the App Store. And think of it like you could change your paywall details like title, description, even pricing. So it's so, so powerful, like background image, colors. It's really, really amazing. So let me just go back to our info. Let's edit this and let's change this to Rebeloper. Why not? Let's save that. Okay, and let's go back to Xcode, build and run once more. Of course, it needs to be fetching it again. And now you see, it says, hello, Rebeloper, just with a switch. Really, really nice. Now, you might be, you know, tempted to not change it all the way to Rebeloper for all users. Hello Qonversion was working kind of fine. Now you want to test how would Hello Rebeloper work. Now that is what we are going to do in the next video, where we are going to learn about experiments. And that's it. Anytime you need to make changes, just edit your remote config. No app release is needed. Once it's set up, you can start running A/B tests to see what actually drives revenue. I'll show you how to do that in the next video.